All right, everybody, welcome back again. Bearded Drums here, your personal drum nerd. Now, keeping up with our ongoing coverage of Namm 2018, we have some more new releases to get to today, so let's go ahead and get started with today's episode. All right, so I have watched more videos, read more articles, and visited many more manufacturers' websites, so we have plenty more releases to talk about today. And if you haven't checked out the previous episode with other new releases, you can follow the link up here to that video, as well as I'll have a link down in the description. In addition to that, there is also a standalone video that I did that talks about the Sabian FRX series of cymbals, and if you haven't seen that yet, there'll be a link down in the description to that as well. So remember, if you like this style of content, go ahead and toss me a like, and if you want to stay up to date on the latest drum gear, pick up little tips and tricks, and do projects with me, consider subscribing to the channel. So let's go ahead and get started with today's new releases, and keep in mind, as always, these are in no particular order. Alright, so first up on our list is the new Vater Extended Play Stick Series. These sticks are going to have a specially formulated, pearl-colored coating on the upper half of the stick that is going to prevent premature chipping and cracking on the tip and the shoulder. Now, as you move down to the middle of the stick, these are going to feature the brand new stick shield from Vater. And this little sleeve is going to protect the middle of the stick from that very common wearing by rimshot. And of course, down on the bottom half of the stick, it's going to have the typical Vater finish, so you have that great grip and feel of the stick. And one thing to keep in mind, if you don't play Vater sticks or you're not going to be looking at the Extended Play series, the stick shield is going to be available for purchase by itself, so you can put it on your own sticks. It's going to be available in a 3-inch stick shield for regular sticks and a 5-inch stick shield for marching sticks. Now, the Extended Play series is going to be available in 5A, 5B, Power 5A, Power 5B, and 3A. They're going to be available in wood or nylon tip, and for the marching drummers, this is also going to be available in the MV7 and MV8. All right, now moving on, Ddrum Dios, who is constantly improving their products and always stepping up their game, as well as working with great drummers like Scott Pellegrom, is now celebrating their 10th anniversary. And with this anniversary, they have released their 24-inch small bell flat ride. Now, this flat ride has beautiful stick definition and a great wash expected from a cymbal of this size, and as well, it has a beautiful hand patina. Now, keep in mind, there are only going to be 100 of these made, so you'll have to grab this one quick. Now, moving on to the drum side of things, Sonor has recently released their AQ2 series of drums. Now, these drums, as well as having that great Sonor quality, is going to be an all maple shell, that's 7-ply. It's going to have 4 plies of Canadian maple and 3 plies of Chinese maple. In addition to that, it is going to feature their new smart mount technology for the toms. It is going to come in 5 different configurations and have some great finishes. Now, I'll put a link below to this product, and keep in mind, all the products we talk about today will all have links to the manufacturer down in the description. Now, in a very cool offering from PDP, they have just released the Eric Hernandez Signature Snare. Now, I'm sure you're all familiar with Eric, also known as E-Panda. That is the drummer and brother of Bruno Mars. Now, this snare, which is awesome looking, is going to be an all maple shell, 6 plies, with a 6-ply reinforcement ring. It's going to feature the mag throw-off. It's going to be available in a 14x4 and a 13x4, as well as sporting some beautiful gold-plated hardware. Now, in all of these episodes, I try to always include a recorder, and Zoom has just released their new F1 field recorder. Now, as far as all the coverage from Namm, I've seen a lot of bad audio, and the Namm floor is very loud, so something like this, especially if you're going to be doing any kind of online talking or interviews, will be perfect for this situation. Now, this little recorder is 24-bit. It records to an SD card. It is going to have a low-cut filter, and it also is going to have limiting control. Now, in addition to that, it is going to be powered by AAA batteries, or you can purchase the power adapter. It is going to have USB connectivity, so you can record directly to an iPad or a laptop. All right, now moving back into some cymbals, Istanbul has extended their exist line of cymbals to now include Ion Dark. Now, these cymbals are going to be a drier, darker take on their exist line. They're going to be very dynamic, complex, with quick decay. Now, what I could find so far is this is going to include a 17 and a 19 dark crash, a 19 dark trash, some 15 dark hats, and a 21-inch dark ride. A very cool offering from Istanbul, especially now that the popular trend for cymbals is leaning more to a darker, trashier sound these days. Now, a very new cool release from George H. Way Drums, which is handled and manufactured now by Ron Danette of Danette Drums, who produces some many fine pieces, has come out with the Carter McLean Signature Snare Drum. Now, if you don't know who Carter McLean is, you need to get online right now, go to YouTube, look him up. Massively popular drummer with an amazing sound. Now, his new signature snare is going to feature rotary cut, two-ply acacia shell with reinforcement rings. And I have seen the videos on this snare. It sounds amazing at all tunings. I highly suggest you give it a look. Now, another drum company that is always super busy releasing new products, especially this year, is SJC Custom Drums. And this year, they have just released their new Heirloom kit. Now, this drum set is sporting some classic looks and vintage tone, and it is even coming in the super awesome vintage custard yellow finish. Now, as far as specs, this is sporting some 6-ply hybrid shells. That's maple, poplar, and mahogany. It also has maple reinforcement rings and some awesome-looking zebra wood bass drum hoops. And in addition to that, it has some very interesting tom sizes. That's going to be 13 by 7.5 on the rack and a 16 by 14 on the floor. Now, in a new release from SJC Drums in their Armada series is their 14 by 7 1mm titanium-shelled snare. Now, this snare drum is going to have a lightly brushed finish. It is going to have rolled bearing edges as well as the snare beds. It's going to have 3mm hoops, and it's going to be available in 6 different options for the hardware. All right, now rounding out our list for today, a new offering from Ddrum and backed by very popular demand is the Dios Maple Series. Now, these drums that haven't been around since about 2012 are back, and they're going to be sporting a thin North American maple shell. Now, it's also going to have 30, 45 degree bearing edges. It's going to have a 20-inch deep kick. It's going to be sporting bullet tube lugs, and it's going to have 2.3mm hoops. Now, the available sizes for these drums are going to be 20, 12, 14, 24, 13, 16, and 22, 10, 12, 14, 16, as well as sporting some very nice finishes. And now the question is for all of you that have been checking out these videos. The one thing I actually wanted to see released at this NAMM and something I've been looking for recently for myself is a brand new stick bag or case. I've looked around. I have seen nobody release anything new. Preferably, I was looking for something freestanding or something that was large enough to hold a lot of sticks and accessories. So this is where I need your help. If anybody out there has seen anything released that I have missed of note, please leave me a comment below. And that's going to wrap up the NAMM update for today. I'm sure that there are some things that I have missed, but there is so much to cover, and I'm trying to keep these videos as short as possible. So if you found anything that I just missed, please leave me a comment below. And if you found this video helpful, toss me a like and consider subscribing to the channel. And as always, hope everyone has a great week. Hope you've enjoyed the NAMM coverage, and I'll see you on the next one.